Open for the 13th of December so that we can get all the tickets sold, because we can't handle that sort of crowd at Kim Annis Park. It was Gold Cup day. We had 10 races on the Gold Cup program. 7 furlongs to the Gold Cup, over $1 million up for grabs, and what an exciting contest it was. We had the horse of the year, reigning horse of the year, Al Safra there. We had the classic winners in there in St. Cecilia. We had Ahufa, the reigning sprint champion. Let's hear the call.
7 furlongs for the Gold Cup, and they're off. It's a very, very level break. Ahufa with the big weight prompts the issue, but there goes St. Cecilia. Al Safra is on the outside, and down on the rails, Regal Selection. Lady Hastings also there too. So it's St. Cecilia, just the leader here. Quicken Grey puts his head in second. Regal Selection is third on the rail. Good Citizen is on the outside. In between horses is Al Safra. Ahufa is also there, and Shanghai Pass. Then comes Lady Hastings, Chadman, Honey of a Lady, and last of all is Rum Talk. This is the way they go towards the 4 furlong point, with in front on the inside, that is St. Cecilia. On the outside, Al Safra. In between horses, the gray is Quicken Grey. They've gone about 4 to 5 lengths clear of Ahufa, a Good Citizen, and Honey of a Lady coming from the back. But it is on the outside, the reigning horse of the year, Al Safra, who hits the front as the Gold Cup field turns for home. St. Cecilia fights on towards the inside. Quicken Grey is down on the rail. Ahufa comes forward with a big weight. Honey of a Lady comes running on wide outside. But it's St. Cecilia as they come inside the final furlong. Ahufa and Honey of a Lady closing best of all. Honey of a Lady flying down the outside. Honey of a Lady's going to win the Gold Cup at the expense of St. Cecilia. St. Cecilia inside, Honey of a Lady outside, and it's close. Looks to be St. Cecilia over Honey of a Lady. Ahufa, Lady Hastings, and Al Safra.
An exciting contest, as the Gold Cup always is. Well-ridden Dick Cardena, St. Cecilia gets their first for Stephen and Valentine Chung and trainer Spencer Chung. Donovan Wilson had a word with Spencer Chung, Stephen Chung, and the winning rider, Dick Cardena.
Congratulations on winning another big...
Field in line for the 39th running of the Pepsi Gold Cup, 7 furlongs. They're off for the Gold Cup. St. Cecilia came out just a bit slow, but recovers quickly. She's the speed in the race, and she gets to that lead with a minimum of fuss. Prime Minister chasing 3 parts back in second. Skittle Queen is on the outside running in third and tightly held up by the rider. Hail the Genius stalks these just a length back, and right alongside him, that's the Gov. Down the back stretch, they've left the 5, and St. Cecilia now bounces easy. She's unmolested, enjoying a 4 or 5 length lead over Prime Minister. Hail the Genius in between horses. Skittle Queen races 3 wide. These 3 abreast as they lead the half-mile marker, and the Gov left at the back of the field as St. Cecilia now makes her way toward the final 3, and she has quickly opened up a huge gap. Hail the Genius, the lightweight, goes in chase. Further back to Skittle Queen, the Gov now ridden hard and asked to go down quickly, quickens and goes into third. Prime Minister at the back, but St. Cecilia cruises into the lane in the Gold Cup. She leaves a quarter pole behind. Hail the Genius now trying to get to her. The Gov is left way back over against the fence. Skittle Queen is way back on the outside of Prime Minister, but St. Cecilia arrives at the furlong. Paul Griffiths now touching her with a right-hand stick. Hail the Genius is eating into the lead, a 16th to run. St. Cecilia battling for dear life. Hail the Genius erupts on the outside, and Hail the Genius will win the Gold Cup over St. Cecilia. The Gov in behind them, Prime Minister and Skittle Queen. In the winner's enclosure, the unofficial winner of today's 10th, the 39th running of the Pepsi Gold Cup, number 4, Hail the Genius, a 6-year-old bear gelding by Hail Orphan, Ingenious by Star Attitude, bred Raphael Gordon, also the owner, trained Gary Sobrati, the second win on the card for Jock. Trainer Lawrence Fremantle asked to go now to the racing office. Trainer Lawrence Fremantle wanted in the racing office. Attention call to the winner's enclosure for the presentation of the Pepsi Gold Cup trophy, kindly donated by Pepsi Cola Jamaica Bottling Company Limited. Making the presentation, Mr. Andrew Reed. He makes it to Cynthia Gordon, representing her husband, Raphael Gordon, owner of Hail the Genius, winner of the Gold Cup. Miss Heather Bulgin presents to the winning trainer, Gary Sobrati. Mr. Logan Campbell presents to the winning breeder, Raphael Gordon. Mr. Hugh Bowen presents to Marvin Campbell, representing the winning jockey, Dick Cardenas. And Mr. George McCullough will present to the winning groom, Errol Thomas.
Horses are taking the track for today's 11th and final. It's a Tropicana Chase. It's a restricted stakes for imported thrills and anonymous of three and maidens. Also native bred thrills, the distance 1400 meters. Number 1, Soleimani, the weight 51 kilos. 4, Excellence, 52. 7, Warrior Queen, 50.5.
Waiting on commanding chief, St. Cecilia. Field and line for the Gold Cup, the 40th running of it. 7 furlongs. They're off for the Gold Cup. St. Cecilia gets a great start, grabs the lead already. Mark my word, going close on the outside of right there on the rail, Emperor Hall, and these three hook up now to battle. Commanding Chief kept to the outside of the gov as no more than 2 3/4 lengths separates them as they run the back stretch and head away toward the 5. St. Cecilia just the leader. Mark my words, slotted in between horses. Emperor Hall right there on the rail. They're stalked by commanding chief and the Gov as they make their way toward the half mile in the Gold Cup. Three horses vying for it. St. Cecilia just kept wide of Mark My Word and Emperor Hall. Commanding Chief going right up with them. And the Gov not too far away to land a blow as they have left the 7/16th and run away now toward the three. And St. Cecilia is loosened and slips away by two lengths. Commanding Chief, the three-year-old, goes in pursuit. Mark My Word, Emperor Hall and the Gov bunching up in behind them. But it's the big filly and the sprint champion, St. Cecilia, who turns for home at the top of the lane in the Gold Cup. Less than 2 furlongs remaining, and the stick now comes out in the left hand. Commanding Chief asked to attack her wide, but still St. Cecilia holds them off with a furlong to run. Commanding Chief toiling in behind. The Governor Emperor Hall racing on the rail. Mark My Word has cried enough. It's St. Cecilia and Shane Ellis. Here's Commanding Chief game and coming late. St. Cecilia looks to have beaten Commanding Chief, Emperor Hall, and the Gov. Coming back to the winner's enclosure, the unofficial winner of the 40th running of the CTL Gold Cup, number 6, St. Cecilia. She's a 5-year-old chestnut mare by Burning Mark. She's on wheels by Bates Motel. Ham Stables Limited, the breeders, Stephen A. and W.P. Valentine Chung, the owners. Second win for Spencer Chung, the third for Shane Ellis. Second 5, Commanding Chief. Third 1, Emperor Hall. Fourth 4, the Gov.
goes in. Field and nine, they're all set. They're off for the Gold Cup. St. Cecilia comes away tugging for that lead. Miss Myrtle Boy Ritchie right there with Traditional Prince on the fence. And Traditional Prince now goes on to get a narrow one over Miss Myrtle Boy Ritchie and St. Cecilia. They form a line of three. They're tracked a length in the three quarters back by Commanding Chief. Sweet Trill possesses speed on the outside. Reasonable Press urged down against the fence. The Govern Mark My Word runners a team. Classy Prospect held seven or eight lengths off the lead. A gap back to noon it is trailing. They're about to arrive at the half mile in the Gold Cup. Miss Myrtle Boy Ritchie and St. Cecilia up front, and now St. Cecilia takes charge. Miss Myrtle Boy Ritchie and Traditional Prince still running right there, just a length and a piece back as they slip past the 3/8 pole. Three lengths back to Commanding Chief, now beginning his effort. Mark My Word needs to do more running. Reasonable Press down against the rail. Classy Prospect and Sweet Trail wide of noon it is, but they're into the lane at the top of the stretch, and it's the horse of the year, St. Cecilia, and the sprint champion who has them off their legs with 3/16 to run. Traditional Prince running a remarkable race, left back in second. Miss Myrtle Boy Ritchie doesn't seem to be able to catch the filly up front. Noon it is racing in behind. Mark My Word down against the fence. It's St. Cecilia. The stick comes out in the left hand. She holds the advantage. Noon it is now comes with a charge on the rail, but St. Cecilia wins the Gold Cup over Noon it is. Traditional Prince close. Could be Miss Myrtle Boy Ritchie over Classy Prospect and Mark My Word. In the winner's enclosure, the unofficial winner of the 41st running of the Gold Cup. Number 9, St. Cecilia, a 6-year-old chestnut mare by Burning Mark. She's on wheels by Bates Motel, Redham Stables Limited, owned Robert F. Chung and W.P. Valentine Chung. Trained Spencer Chung, the rider Shane Ellis. Second to 3, noon it is. The third, 4, Traditional Prince. 4/8, Miss Myrtle Boy Ritchie. Running time, 1400 meters, 1 minute 24. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention called to the winner's enclosure for the presentation of the 41st running of the Gold Cup, donated by Caymanis Track Limited. Making the presentation, Mr. Franz Jobson, CEO, Caymanis Track Limited. He makes it to trainer Spencer Chung on behalf of Robert F. Chung and W.P. Valentine Chung, owners of the Gold Cup winner, St. Cecilia. Horses loading for the Catherine Speak sponsored Gold Cup. 7 furlongs. Waiting on Kipling Weekend. Starter on his rostrum. Track now clear for racing. Kipling Weekend. Hesitating to load gate one. Now goes in. Field in line for the Gold Cup. Sponsored by Catherine Speak. They're all set to go. They're off for the Gold Cup. Classy prospect. Just a shade slowly out. Opportune comes away quickly. There goes Kipling Weekend, coupling up and rushing into that lead as they chase down the backstretch. Opportune settled 3 lengths in behind in second. Commanding Chief racing on the outside. Classy prospect on the rail. Argument done in between horses. As they go down the backstretch, Blast Them Away forms a line of three there. 2.5 lengths back to Exotic Gold and a Go-Go Yvonne being niggled at the back. They're running away toward the final half mile. Kipling Weekend and Opportune, they blaze that trail up front and go at it hammer and thong as they slip into the half mile turn. Commanding Chief now moves up to take them on. Argument Done and Blast Them Away just 4 lengths off the lead as they now make their way toward the final three. Exotic Gold is further back. Classy Prospect now asks for an effort and a Go-Go Yvonne continues to labor at the back. 5/16 remaining and now Commanding Chief is asked to attack Opportune. They're into the lane. Blast Them Away and Argument Done are the ones on the outside of Kipling Weekend. It's Commanding Chief at the 3/16 with the lead in the Gold Cup. Opportune trying to fight on. Kipling Weekend over on the rail. Blast Them Away on the outside, making hard work of it. Exotic Gold on the extreme outside. It is Commanding Chief in his orange silks inside the final 16th. Commanding Chief waltzing home with the Gold Cup. Commanding Chief wins it. It's tight. Argument Done maybe second over Blast Them Away, then Opportune. Entering the winner's enclosure, the unofficial winner of the Catherine Speak Gold Cup, number 8, Commanding Chief, a 5-year-old chestnut gelding by War Marshall, She Knows Bo by Bo Genius, bred Paul Chen, owned Doc Stable Train, Everell Francis, the third win on the card for jockey Paul Francis. Second 3, Argument Done, third 7, Blast Them Away, fourth 4, Opportune. Running time, 1400 meters, 1 minute 25 and 3/5.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention called to the winner's enclosure for the presentation of the 42nd running of the Gold Cup, sponsored by Catherine Peak. Making the presentation, Mr. Michael Bernard, Chairman, Peak Bottling Company Limited. He makes it to Orett Wellington on behalf of the winning owner of Commanding Chief Doc's Stable. Mr. David Wong, Managing Director, Peak Bottling Company Limited, presents to Sylvester Green on behalf of the winning trainer, Everell Francis. Mr. David Wong presents to Orett Wellington on behalf of the winning breeder, Paul Chen. Mr. David Magnus, Sales and Marketing Manager, Peak Bottling Company Limited, presents to the winning jockey. Nikkei now moving up toward gate 3. Starter on his rostrum as they get set for the Gold Cup. Track clear for racing. All set to go. They're off for the Gold Cup. Sponsored by Wasi Bike, Gogo Ivan gives the rest a huge jump. As expected, Crucial Appeal goes charging up for that lead. Traditional Prince is there, along with the talented Tony K racing on the rail. Opportune now moves up to take the front runners on as they charge down the backstretch. Pacino's made some ground in between horses. Traditional Prince toward the outside. Campesino races right there on the fence, some 5 lengths off the lead. Franfield running out wide. Exotic Gold is there. Perfect Neighbor on the extreme outside. Pete's Wild One now beginning to make some progress along with Typewriter. All Correct left to the outside. The Gov toward the back along with the trailer. Go-Go Yvonne as they've left the half mile and slip past the 7-16th. The talented Tony K, Crucial Appeal, and Opportune. These three now in tight fist as they're about to arrive at the 5-16th. They're going to come into the lane in the Gold Cup. Opportune in between horses. Talented Tony K toward the outside. Crucial Appeal is racing widest of them all. Traditional Prince just in behind in the yellow cap, beginning to make some ground. That is Pacino, but Talented Tony K over on the rail is the first to crack. Opportune traveling strongly. Here now is Pacino beginning his challenge. Traditional Prince on the outside, left out of it at this stage. That appears to be Campesino, but they drive toward the line, and it is Pacino who has the lead and wins the Gold Cup. Opportune is second. Pete's Wild One has finished third, and then we have Franfield on the outside in behind those Typewriter. In the winner's enclosure, the unofficial winner of the 43rd running of the Gold Cup, sponsored by Wasi Bike. 5 Pochin, a 5-year-old big gelding by Traditional, Bubblegum Hearty by Hermitage, bred Percival E. Tomlinson. This is the second win for Cora Jamaica Agency and Robert Pearson. The rider O'Brien White. Second to 6, Opportune. Third, 7, Pete's Wild One. Fourth, 12, Franfield. Fifth, 10, Typewriter. Running time, 1400 meters, 1:24.4. Horses going to the testing bar. Result now official. First 5, Pochin, $197 to win, 86 to place. Second 6, Opportune, $209. Third 7, Pete's Wild One, $212. Fourth 12, Franfield. Fifth 10, Typewriter. The trifecta, $792. Exacta, $1,264. Quinella, 703. W Event, 1,178. Six high fives, $16,702.50. 21 triples, $8,031. Splits, 23-3, 46-1, 1:10.4. 7 furlongs raced in 1:24.4. Margins won by 1.5. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention drawn to the winner's enclosure for the presentation of the 43rd running of the Gold Cup, sponsored by Wasi Bike, kindly donated by Alex's Import Limited. Making the presentation, Mr. Alexander Haber, CEO, Alex's Import Limited. He makes it to Matthew Pragnell, representing Cora Jamaica Agency, owners of the winner, Pochin, Mrs. Esmin Haber. We'll present to the winning trainer, Robert Pearson. Miss Shanti Haber, daughter of Alexander Haber, will present to Robert Pearson on behalf of the winning breeder, Percival E. Tomlinson. Mr. Keeson Ferguson, purchasing manager, Alex's Imports Limited, will present to the winning jockey, O'Brien White. And Mr. Keeson Ferguson, purchasing manager, will present to the winning groom. Robert Pearson will receive on behalf of Frank Spencer. In today's 12th and final, number 4, Grand Corazon, make the rider Kuri Powell. Kuri Powell rides 4, Grand Corazon. Shamari Muir replaces Shane Ellis on 5, Shade of Beauty. 5, Shade of Beauty, Shamari Muir. They've loaded. Field in line for the Gold Cup. 7 furlongs to race. They're all set. They're off for the Gold Cup. And Fortune 100 comes away at the back. Phineas keeps him company. Opportune in the red cap as expected goes for that lead. Worried early by Uncle Taff. Perfect Neighbor settled just in behind them. Fortune 100 racing down against the rail. Pochin has kept some 6 lengths off that lead. Followed up by Phineas now moving by the trailer. Scoop Jordine. Down the back stretch they go in the Gold Cup. They run past the 5. It's Fortune 100 testing up a tune all the while. A neck separates them. Uncle Taff sitting in the dicky seat right there in third spot as they're arriving at the half mile and go spinning into that turn. Perfect Neighbor races some 4.5 to 5 lengths off the lead. Pochin now asked to get going on the outside of Phineas as they ring past the 7/16th and run to the 3. Forget Scoop. Jordine back at the back and a long way last. Up a tune has kicked for home. Arriving at the 5/16th with that lead, being chased up by Uncle Taff on the outside. Fortune 100 there or thereabouts. Perfect Neighbor has a lot to do from where he is against the rail. Pochin now asked to close the gap. Up a tune with 3/16 remaining. Uncle Taff trying to worry him all the time. Fortune 100 racing in behind him. Perfect Neighbor gets the run against the rail and comes a calling. Up a tune with that lead. What? Perfect Neighbor now charging at him on the rail. It's up a tune. Perfect Neighbor in the red cap now kicking in. Ben Perfect Neighbor grabs the lead and wins the Gold Cup from Opportune, Uncle Taff, and Phineas. In the winner's enclosure, the unofficial winner of the 44th running of the Gold Cup, sponsored by Alex's Import, number 2, Perfect Neighbor, a 5-year-old dark bay horse by Natural Selection, Desperate Housewife by Ghost Ransom, bred YS, 1955 Limited, owned Alfred Lee and Jeffrey Mordecai, the second win on the card for trainer Wayne DaCosta OD, also the second for jockey Robert Halladine. Second one, Opportune, third, 3, Uncle Taff, fourth, 5, Phineas. Running time, 1,400 meters, 1 minute 24 3/5.
Attention, please, ladies and gentlemen. Your attention is directed to the winner's enclosure for the presentation of the Alex Imports Gold Cup, kindly donated by Alex Imports Limited. Making the presentation to the winning owner is Mr. Kirk Nurse to Jeffrey Mordecai. Kirk Nurse now makes the presentation to the winning trainer, Wayne DaCosta. Kirk Nurse to the winning trainer, Wayne DaCosta, OD. To the winning breeder, Errol Barrett, trainer Wayne DaCosta will receive on behalf of the winning breeder. Orlando Cottrell will receive from Errol Barrett on behalf of the winning rider. And Janice Cooper will present to the winning groom on behalf of the winning groom, Mr. Anthony Getfield. So congratulations to all concerned, as Perfect Neighbor wins the 44th running of the Gold Cup. Kindly sponsored, and we thank you once again, Mr. Alex Habo of Alex Imports Limited.
This is the 44th running of the Gold Cup, sponsored by Alex Is Import. Still waiting on Braun, in the colors of Mycross. Now goes in, field in line, for the Alex Is Import sponsored Gold Cup. They're all ready to go. They're off for the Gold Cup. Fair start. Hovercraft missed it, along with Blue Dixie and Houdini's Magic. Gary Glitter shows early speed, leads up by a half a length. Buzz Nightmare settled in second as they go flashing past the six. Seeking My Dream and Blue Dixie race together. Phineas joins them. Typewriter hidden from view on the outside of Long Running Train. Houdini's Magic is next, maybe 8 or 10 lengths off that lead. A length back to Braun, and Hovercraft has a lot to do from there. The Gold Cup field run to the half mile. They're almost there, about to go into the turn. And Buzz Nightmare now applies pressure to Gary Glitter. And Buzz Nightmare makes his move and gets that lead over Gary Glitter. Seeking My Dream moving swiftly down into third. Phineas under a ride in fourth. Followed up by Blue Dixie, who has made some progress. 2 lengths further back to Typewriter asked to close. Braun now begins his run on the outside of horses. Houdini's Magic is left with the back markers. Long Running Train and Hovercraft. But it's Buzz Nightmare first into the lane in the Gold Cup. Buzz Nightmare, they've got to catch him. Seeking My Dream now asked to pull him in. Gary Glitter is over on the rail with Phineas right against it. It's a Buzz Nightmare getting cracks of that stick on the run past the furlong pole. Buzz Nightmare, a burly sort. He's fighting them off in the Gold Cup. Buzz Nightmare holding them off. Buzz because Nightmare wins the Gold Cup over Phineas and Braun, close between Houdini's Magic and Seeking My Dream for fourth. In the winner's enclosure, the unofficial winner of the 44th running of the Alex's Import sponsored Gold Cup. 7 Buzz Nightmare, 4-year-old Bay Colt by Into Mischief, Queen of Battle by Dance Brightly. Bedham Stables Limited, own 2 Penny, train Philip Fiani OD, the rider O'Neill Mullings. It's the second win on the card for O'Neill Mullings. Second goes to 9 Phineas, 3rd 10 Braun, 4th 2 Houdini's Magic. Running time 1400 meters, 1:23.4.
Attention, ladies and gentlemen, your attention directed to the winner's enclosure for the presentation of the Alex's Import Gold Cup. Kindly donated by Alex's Import Limited. First presentation will go to the winning owner. Representing the winning owner is Lisa Hannah Harris. Presentation being made by Mr. Marlon Kelly, General Manager, Alex's Import Limited. Next will be the presentation to the winning trainer, Philip Fiani OD. Presentation will be made by Mr. Marlon Kelly, General Manager, Alex's Import. So Mr. Marlon Kelly, now to trainer Philip Vianney, OD, many time champion trainer. We can't find Mr. Vianney. Oh, there he is. The winning breeder will be represented by Mr. Alfred Brown, Mr. Kirk Nurse, marketing and social media manager of Alex's Import. We'll make the presentation to Mr. Alfred Brown, representing the winning breeder. To the winning jockey, Mr. Kirk Nurse, will make the presentation to veteran rider O'Neill Mullings for a job extremely well done. Congratulations. Mr. Alfred Brown will also receive, on behalf of the winning groom, Mr. Kesson Ferguson, inventory manager of Alex's Import, will make the presentation to Mr. Alfred Brown, representing the winning groom. Also in the presentation party, CTL managing director, Mr. Shane Dalling, and part owner of the winning horse, Herbie Chung. We take this opportunity of thanking Alex's Import for their kind sponsorship.
The runners are taking the track for today's 11 fun final. It's Alex's Import.
Rider climbing aboard. Field in line. They're off for the Gold Cup. Royal Vibes came off at the back with Lottery Ticket and Chase the Great. So Budget as expected goes for that lead and gets it over Choo Choo Blue. Seeking My Dream is early. There goes Houdini's Magic now rushing up to take Sir Budget on as they make their way down the back stretch. Choo Choo Blue settled right there in third. Seeking My Dream taken off them, back in fourth with Gary Glitter. Chase the Great Ass to close up on the outside, another bullet. Orpheus racing in behind them. A gap opens up to Lottery Ticket and Royal Vibes as the Gold Cup field arrive at the half mile. The speed should increase and Sir Budget continues to fend off Houdini's Magic. A pesky one on the outside, just a neck separates them. A length and a half back to Choo Choo Blue. Watch Orpheus going down on the outside.
of another bullet. Chase the Great now wound up and beginning to make ground, just 5 lengths off that lead. Gary Glitter is under the pump and needs to do more as they leave the 5/16th. In behind them, that Seeking My Dream, then Lottery Ticket and Royal Vibes. But the field turned for home, and it's Houdini's Magic. Here is Choo Choo Blue. Sir Budget looks to have given way. Chase the Great finding room in between horses and claiming the rail run. These are the three main dangers. Gary Glitter is racing out wide. They leave the furlong pole. Choo Choo Blue with that lead over Houdini's Magic and Chase the Great. Lottery Ticket is further back, and coming on late it is Choo Choo Blue that wins the Gold Cup over Lottery Ticket, Houdini's Magic and Chase the Great. Returning to the winner's enclosure, the unofficial winner of the 45th running of the Gold Cup, number 2, Choo Choo Blue. She's a 4-year-old bay filly by Cowtown Cat, Choo 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 Blue by Bulger. Bred Brent and Crystal Fimong. Old Miss Suki trained Peter McMaster. Dane Dawkins has his second win on the card. Second goes to 3, Lottery Ticket. Third, 11, Houdini's Magic. And 4th to 5, Chase the Great. Running time, 1400 meters, 1:23.4. Result now official. Horses going to the testing barn. 2, Choo Choo Blue. 3, Lottery Ticket. 4, Royal Vibes. 5, Chase the Great. 2, 3, 4, 5 all go to the testing barn dividends. First 2, Choo Choo Blue. $260 to win, 88 to place. Second 3, Lottery Ticket, $97. Third 11, Houdini's Magic, $131. Fourth 5, Chase the Great. Fifth 1, Gary Glitter. The trifecta, $2,079. Exacta, $1,111. Quinella, $844. Double Event, $1,502. Four high fives, 47,005. 31 triples, 5,173. Splits, 23-1, 45-3, 1-10-2. Final time, a quick 1:23.4. The margins, 1 3/4 by 3/4.
Ventures Racing and Entertainment Limited. To the winning owner, Mrs. Elaine McMaster. Presentation to be made by Mr. Brando Hayden, Chief Operating Officer, Supreme Ventures and Racing Entertainment Limited. Elaine McMaster receiving, affectionately called Miss Suki. The winning trainer, Peter McMaster. You've done a fantastic job with 2-2 Blue, Mr. McMaster. Excellent job. Rando Hayden makes the presentation. Mr. Peter McMaster will also receive, on behalf of the winning breeder, Mr. Brando Hayden also makes that presentation. Mr. Denzel Miller Jr., Racing Secretary, Supreme Ventures Racing and Entertainment Limited, to the winning jockey. Mr. Dane Dawkins, who has certainly come to hand at the back end of 2017. Just keep your nose out of it, Mr. Dane. Keep it clear and straight. Walk the thin line. And maybe one day you'll be the champion jockey. And to the winning groom, Denzel Miller Jr. will present to Javon, the groom's son. Congratulations to all concerned. The Gold Cup was worth coming miles to see. And coming up soon, we've got some changes for you. There'll be a new pick nine. Yes, the
field in line for the Gold Cup. They're off. She's a man-eater, just a bit slowly out. Siempre Bueno is expected, moves quickly to the early lead. Will in Charge is on the rail, Houdini's Magic right alongside. Two lengths back to another bullet, Chase the Great runs the rail. Perfect Neighbor on the outside and She's a Man-eater in between them as the field charge down the back stretch and head away now toward the final five. Houdini's Magic now takes a slim lead over Siempre Bueno rated. Will in Charge is breathing right down their necks. Chase the Great, another bullet, and She's a Man-eater pile up in behind. And just at the back of the field, it is Perfect Neighbor, but no more than five lengths separates them as they have left the half mile and run toward the 7/16th, and it's a Will in Charge. She's a Man-eater now moving into second quickly over another bullet. Chase the Great is hugging the rail and cuts the corner as the Gold Cup field will arrive at the 5/16th. Further back to Houdini's Magic and Perfect Neighbor, and then Siempre Bueno, but they turn for home, and it's Will in Charge at the top of the lane. She's a Man-eater now unleashed toward the outside. Chase the Great is over on the rail right alongside another bullet, but Will in Charge continues to power on. A furlong to run. Will in Charge in the Gold Cup. She's a Man-eater not finding enough. Another bullet in between horses. Chase the Great over on the rail, and it's Will in Charge. Large and in charge. Will in Charge will win the 46th running of the Cow's Tomato Ketchup Gold Cup. It's close. Another bullet looks to be second over. She's a Man-eater and Chase the Great. In the winner's enclosure, the unofficial winner of today's ninth, the 46th running of the Cow's Tomato Ketchup Gold Cup, Number 3, Will in Charge, a 5-year-old chestnut horse by Adore the Gold, Gem Lee by Meadowflight. Bredham Stables Limited, owned WB Racing. Train Robert Pearson, the rider, Robert Halladine. Second 6, Another Bullet. The third 1, She's a Manita. Fourth 2, Chase the Great. Running time, 1400.
Of this year by Carl's Manufacturing Limited. Making the presentation is Mr. Carl's Manufacturing himself, Mr. Carlton Watson. Receiving on behalf of the winning connections, Lorna Bagwandine, who will receive that magnificent gold cup along with 1 gallon of Carl's tomato ketchup, 10 bags of feed. Mr. Carlton Watson will also present to the winning trainer, Robert Pearson. He doesn't have many horses, but he has done a fantastic job. Congratulations, Robert. Mr. Watson presents to the winning trainer, who will also receive a Carl's gift basket. And now Horse of the Year honors up in the air. Will it be the girl or will it be the boy? We still have the Super Stakes to come and the Diamond Mile. Lisa Watson, Director of Carl's Manufacturing Limited, will present to the winning breeder, also received by Lorna Bagwandine. Lisa Watson will also present to the winning jockey, being represented by Ludlow Johnson, Carl's gift basket. Lisa Watson will present to the winning groom, being represented by Nicholas Ward. Six-pack Real Vibes, all courtesy of Carl's Manufacturing. Also in the presentation party, Mr. Hugo Douglas, and of course, the gold man himself, Mr. Wilbert Bagwandine. Again, we take this opportunity to thank Mr. Carlton Watson for their kind sponsorship of the Gold Cup. Mr. Watson, a great friend of racing. Thank you, sir.
And in the blindfold, that's another bullet being pushed forward. Track clear for racing. Another bullet in. We're ready for the 48th running of the Gold Cup. 7 furlongs. Small field of 5. They're off for the Gold Cup. Another bullet staggers out at the back. She's a Man-Eater and Money Magnet mix it up early. Saratoga side caught by another bullet, who now moves at those leaders. Hovercraft is at the back of the field, but only 5 lengths separates them as they leave the 6. Another bullet going at it with Money Magnet. She's a Man-Eater staying right on their heels. Saratoga side is further back and racing in 4th, and Hovercraft cruising along in 5th as they leave the 5 and run the back stretch with another bullet out in front. She's a Man-Eater now pressing on the outside. Money Magnet is right with them as they're about to arrive at the half mile and go rushing into the turn, and She's a Man-Eater on the outside now picks up a narrow lead over another bullet. This looks to be a match race as Money Magnet has cried enough already. Saratoga side is left back in behind with Hovercraft last as they've left the 3 and come toward the 5/16th and the top of the lane. She's a Man-Eater in charge. She's a Man-Eater out in front. Another bullet chasing, but it looks to be in vain. Walker hands alone at the top of the lane. Less than a quarter of a mile to run. He pulls out the stick in the right hand, and She's a Man-Eater is pouring it on. Another bullet chasing best of the rest. Saratoga sight running on the rail where he likes. Money Magnet in the center and Hovercraft at the back. But She's a Man-Eater, the queen of local racing, has left the 16th pole. This will be her 22nd win from 28 starts as she romps the Gold Cup by 6 or more over another bullet. Money Magnet, Hovercraft, and Saratoga sight.
She's a Man-Eater delivers as the 1-5 favourite and scores an immaculate victory here in the Gold Cup. up by over 7 lengths, Wayne. A pretty fine effort there from your big 5-year-old mare.
She never stops pleasing us. I mean, she has done everything asked of her so far. And one really wondered what she has left in store for us. So far, so good.
We saw the time at 1:25, which is not a particularly fast time. We don't know exactly what the track conditions are like, but 1:25 seconds for the 7-furlong run here for She's a Man-Eater. Nothing to write home about, even though she won with a lot in hand.
Well, what the jockey said when he came back was that once she got to the front, she started to idle. There was no competition, and she's like that in the morning. Once you give her a competition, she'll go faster, and once you take it away, she'll go slow. So she's one of those horses that just wins, do what she has to do to win.
You have said in the past that this will be her last year in racing. 2 minutes ago, you say you're not sure what she has left in store. Are you reconsidering signing her off in 2019?
No, I'm talking about a Diamond Mile. in a race in which you're going to get good competition, because more than likely she's going to buck up Stranger Danger there.
What are your thoughts about Stranger Danger, who is also in your barn, matching up against She's a Man-Eater?
Extremely talented colt. Still in the same class as Man-Eater at the moment. Some people say that he's better than Man-Eater, but the proof of the pudding is going to be in the eating, because she's a tough not to beat.
You're divorcing yourself from the issue, Wayne. You're saying some people feel she's better than She's a Man-Eater. What does the trainer think?
I'll prefer not to say, but the 130 and 350 he did 2 weeks ago with 126 pounds definitely augurs well for a very interesting battle.
Thank you very much, Wayne, and congratulations.
Thank you.
Wayne DeCoster, champion trainer, and scores his 5th Gold Cup win and his 2nd in 5 years after Perfect Neighbor won for him in 2015. She's a Man-Eater, clocks 1:25 seconds even and wins the Gold Cup by a massive 7¾ of a length.
Result of the 6th now official. Horses to the testing barn. 1 Another Bullet. 2 Saratoga Sight. 4 Hovercraft. 5 She's a Man-Eater. 1, 2, 4, 5 all go to the testing barn. The winner 5 She's a Man-Eater. $63 to win. 2nd 1 Another Bullet. 3rd 3 Money Magnet. 4th 4 Hovercraft. Trifecta $26. Exacta $91. Double $186. 85 triples, 2,344 each. 15 winners of the pick 5, 16,000, 7, 7, 5, and 50 cents. Single winner bonus in the pick 5, 3 million, 795,000, 793 and 69 cents. 21 winners of the Sunrise 6, 91,711 each. The splits are 24, 46, 4, 111. Final time, 125. Margins 7¼ by 3¼. Small field of 5. They're off for the Gold Cup. Another Bullet staggers out at the back. She's a Man-Eater and Money Magnet mix it up early. Saratoga Sight caught by Another Bullet, who now moves at those leaders. Hovercraft is at the back of the field, but only 5 lengths separates them as they leave the 6. Another Bullet going at it with Money Magnet. She's a Man-Eater staying right on their heels. Saratoga Sight is further back and racing in 4th, and Hovercraft cruising along in 5th as they leave the 5 and run the back stretch with Another Bullet out in front. She's a Man-Eater now pressing on the outside. Money Magnet is right with them as they're about to arrive at the half mile and go rushing into the turn, and
She's a man-eater on the outside, now picks up a narrow lead over another bullet. This looks to be a match race, as Money Magnet has cried enough already. Saratoga Sight is left back in behind with Hovercraft last, as they've left the three and come toward the 5/16th and the top of the lane. She's a man-eater in charge. She's a man-eater out in front. Another bullet chasing, but it looks to be in vain. Walker hands alone at the top of the lane. Less than a quarter of a mile to run. He pulls out the stick in the right hand, and She's a man-eater is pouring it on. Another bullet chasing best of the rest. Saratoga Sight running on the rail where he likes. Money Magnet in the center and Hovercraft at the back. But She's a man-eater, the queen of local racing, has left the 16th pole. This will be her 22nd win from 28 starts as she romps the Gold Cup by six or more over another bullet. Money Magnet, Hovercraft, and Saratoga Sight.
Ms. Carcia Gale, acting customer service manager, will present to the representative of the winning groom being Christo Anthony, receiving on his behalf Elizabeth Acosta, the wife of the winning trainer. Congratulations to the She's a Manita crew.